Hi, Deon.
Hi, Rebecca.
So thank you so much to come for this interview to talk about cryptocurrency market and the UK professional, you know, networking market in general.
Thank you for inviting me here. I'm very happy to give my opinions and thoughts on the subject.
Brilliant. So why don't you start by introducing yourself briefly?
Okay, so yeah. My name is Deon. I'm a British-born Chinese here in the UK. I have worked across different companies in large financial institutions. I'm currently a project manager in a large insurance company. I also have a background in entrepreneurship, having run and started a company to help Chinese students find a job in the UK, which is still running to this day.
That's so nice.
And lastly, I started a big Chinese network for Chinese professionals across financial services, or the banks, or the big four, and law firms, Chinese lawyers, all coming together. We bring communities of Chinese people together to create these massive large events, to network, and ultimately build a better Chinese community in the UK.
That's so nice of you. So I've actually been to one of your drinks by EB. Yeah. So speaking of entrepreneurship, would you like to share more of your thoughts on entrepreneurship, especially among Chinese people in the UK?
Yes, there are quite a lot of budding entrepreneur students, Chinese students in the UK. From what I've seen in the market, a lot of them are trying to start their companies and use the advantage of them being in the West, physically in the West, while using their Chinese background to either innovate and create new products or take what they've learned from the West and bring it back to the East. So I've seen many examples, and I think the community is growing. I think I've seen a few incubators in the UK, specifically for the Chinese population here. And yeah, I think the future is bright. I think a lot of, you know, as the world becomes more integrated, there's going to be a lot more opportunities for Chinese people to start their businesses and hopefully create large corporations out of them.
Thanks. So I think that's actually quite relevant to the DACC, which is also a newly established technology company that's majored in blockchain technology. Great. So a little bit introduction to DACC. So DACC stands for Decentralized Accessible Content Chain, which means we are trying to use the blockchain technology to better secure or manage information and data. You know, to use the because you know blockchain is decentralized, so it's actually much secured and can be a very good platform that benefits the content creators. So by eliminating the middle persons, those big central platforms like YouTube or Youku or even Google, so we are trying to make the content creators to benefit more.
Yes, yes.
So speaking of this, do you think data and information, especially the security of that, is very essential to what you are doing now?
In terms of project management, or maybe the networking.
Yeah.
So I've got two things to say actually. So from what you guys are doing in terms of creating a blockchain in order to, like you said, decentralize contractual obligations, especially cross-border, because I hear that in the music industry or in any content generation industry, contractual obligations when it comes mm-hmm. to payments of royalties
mm-hmm.
Becomes incredibly complex
mm-hmm.
and time consuming when mm-hmm. you're trying to let the other people and other service providers use your content. So I do think there's a big massive market for that blockchain technology
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
and it's been well documented out there. In terms of what I am doing,
mm-hmm.
I'd say nothing complex, as complex as blockchain, but
mm-hmm.
we do value our data
mm-hmm.
Quite importantly, because we capture
mm-hmm.
event attendees and
mm-hmm.
we like to, you know, we like to keep that data secure.
Mm-hmm.
We don't want intruders seeing who comes to our events.
Mm-hmm.
We also want to make sure that people whose data that we hold, we have the right permissions
mm-hmm.
in order to use their data
mm-hmm.
and not share it with other third-party providers
without
their consent. So yeah, data is extremely important
mm-hmm.
nowadays, and yeah, I think the world is moving towards a more secure, more people are a lot more concerned about the security of their data.
Yeah, precisely. So so speaking of blockchain, I know you have a lot of connections, or you have been working with a lot of Chinese entrepreneurs, especially in the UK. So have you seen many investing or working on blockchain here?
Yeah, I have seen one example
mm-hmm.
of a person that's actually starting a blockchain company as well.
Mm-hmm.
And one thing I learned from that is actually a lot of it is about perception
mm-hmm.
because, you know, value is in the value of a cryptocurrency
mm-hmm.
or a blockchain. Basically the context is he's trying to create his own cryptocurrency.
Yeah.
And it's important for that particular person to
mm-hmm.
make sure everything is and looks the
mm-hmm.
best it can be
mm-hmm.
because if you come in and talk to very rich investors, they want to see that, you know, this is something of value, this looks good, this looks amazing, this
mm-hmm.
is what people want to buy into, and it's all about generating that perception that this is valuable.
So
I have a come across one person that is starting a UK-China cryptocurrency.
Oh, cool.
And yeah, and that's one of the things I picked up from him.
So basically, the not exactly a lot of people venturing into the blockchain industry in the UK.
Oh, no, I think there's a lot of people.
Oh, really?
There's definitely a lot of people.
I'm not sure whether I'm right, because I know blockchain is mainly very popular, I mean currently, in the developing countries, for countries you know experience inflation.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah, but blockchain is not just for cryptocurrencies,
mm-hmm,
right?
Exactly.
It can be used, as you said, for
payments.
Anything payments related.
Yeah.
Blockchain is big in trade finance.
Yeah.
Where when you're basically where you are transferring goods from one country to
mm-hmm.
another country and you need
mm-hmm.
to go through that set of
mm-hmm.
large documentation. And these are problems that don't just affect developing countries, they
mm-hmm.
affect developed countries.
Yeah.
So there are many, many applications for
mm-hmm.
blockchain. And we're seeing a lot of the big corporate companies,
mm-hmm.
especially the big four, big tech houses
mm-hmm.
starting on developing their own IP
mm-hmm.
in order to capitalize on it and sell it to clients,
mm-hmm.
right? So we're seeing a lot of that
mm-hmm.
in the developed world.
Well, that's very useful information for me. So moving to the next question, I'm not sure whether you are aware of that. So basically, cryptocurrency investing involves a lot of community operating and managing.
Mm.
So basically, you have to effectively manage a community so that you keep your investors updated and you give them trust, basically.
Yes, yes.
So you keep them investing. So why not share to us some of your experience on you know, building or managing or operating a community?
I think some of the words you just mentioned
mm-hmm.
really resonates with building a successful community.
Mm-hmm.
For example, building trust.
Yeah.
You know, trust can come in many, many different forms and aspects.
Mm-hmm.
One of which is, you know, using the data correctly, as we mentioned
mm-hmm.
before.
Mm-hmm.
But also, when we create events, making these events exactly what they want it to be, finding out what the market wants,
mm-hmm.
and giving them exactly what people want in terms of, you know, they come into our events, they expect this to be high quality, you know, good attendance, good atmosphere.
Yeah.
And the community we build, we have a process where we ensure that everything is as perfect as possible.
Mm-hmm.
And all of this contributes to trust.
Yeah.
Because once we build a good relationship, once they know who we are and what
mm-hmm.
we do, then the trust builds.
Mm-hmm.
And this is trust is not something that can be measured by, you know, a currency or a value, but it's something that once you have it, it's invaluable.
Yeah, I totally agree with you on this, and I also think trust is, you know, the core of managing a community, is, you know, successfully. So coming to our last question, and it's a bit of personal question. Do you see yourself a, you know, cryptocurrency investor maybe in the near future?
Well, potentially.
Mm-hmm.
It really depends on many different factors.
Mm-hmm.
I think one of the biggest things I have to think about before investing
mm-hmm.
is, you know, like uptake.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you would want to treat cryptocurrency
mm-hmm.
as any form of investment, right?
Yeah.
So you'd have to look at the fundamentals.
Mm-hmm.
You'd have to, you know, see what the short-term future
mm-hmm.
and the medium-term and the long-term.
Mm-hmm.
And especially, I know that there are many cryptocurrencies
mm-hmm.
out there. So all of that would factor into my decision making.
Yeah.
And if there is a standout one,
okay,
it could be from your company. It
okay.
It could be Bitcoin. It could
mm-hmm.
be Ethereum. But if there is a standout one, has a high uptake,
mm-hmm.
and I would definitely consider it because
mm-hmm.
I do feel like the benefits of a cryptocurrency.
Mm-hmm.
is definitely real.
Yeah.
And there is value
mm-hmm.
in that.
Okay, thank you. So I think we have come to an end to our interview today. And I'm really glad to have invited Deon to be my guest. And I hope maybe one day the DACC can venture to the UK market eventually. And thank you.
Cool, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Cheers.